Here's Diamantopoulos. That's good.
You know, huge height advantage there, but because of the great body control, he's able to cancel it out.
Agreed. The body control essential in that situation. I mean, if you're giving up a bunch of height, then you better be able to manufacture things in the air.
Alexander's checked in for Paul. And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The scoring breakdown for the Timberwolves.
Well, I like the fact they've already been getting a lot of high-quality shots in the paint.
Also, guys, the passing has been terrific in the first half. They'll be happy with all those assists.
So on the floor for the Bronx, we've got Tim Hardaway Jr., Hayward out there with Porzingis, and it's Alexander in at the five. Here's Alexander to the middle. And here in the first quarter, with a little over 3.5 minutes played, falls through. He's now made 2 of 4.
Yeah, heads-up aggressive play right there. Saw the smaller man on him and took it straight to the basket.
And he gets the bucket.
Those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten in the first half here.
And I think they should continue to work the ball down low, Clark. It's really going to free up their outside shooting.
Now here's Hayward. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Guys, I had a chance to catch up with the Minnesota Timberwolves head coach. He told me that as hard as it may be to believe, in an atmosphere as intense as Game 7 of the NBA Finals, it's almost hard to be nervous. There's just too much going on. He said, we're ready to get to the task at hand. We know exactly what we need to do. Can they do it? That's the question, Kevin.
Thanks again, Doris. The Bronx trails by 4. Kicks it to Hardaway. Pass to Porzingis. Back to Hardaway. Three-pointer, and he gets it to go.
They really can't allow him too many open looks like that. I mean, that's just inviting trouble.
Timberwolves have gotten 6 of 7 shots to fall in the first quarter. They're off and running. The feed to Joseph. No luck. The Bronx goes the other way with it. They easily took Thursday's game.
They just weren't challenged. I mean, nearly as much as they should have been in that game, at least when they had the ball.
Yeah, it was a mismatch. I mean, the defense from the start was on its heels practically the entire game.
And Minnesota has possession after the Bronx got the three-pointer and the foul called on Tim Hardaway Jr. That's his first foul. Over to the left wing. Right side, Jackson. They set the pick. Soft touch off the glass. Jackson's got his second bucket.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
That's right. 5 of their last 6 makes were on the interior. They've established their inside presence.
Here's Porzingis. 7 points in the game. To the paint. Out to Hardaway. Lock at 6. Minnesota with the rebound.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
And Towns gets it to go.
Well, that's one way he can finish, but far from the only way he gets it done. He's got all kinds of tricks up his sleeve. You know what? I think he thinks he can make a few improvements to how things are going on right now.
Yeah, and you know, coaches always are looking for ways to tweak things and change it up a little bit, no matter what the situation is. That's what coaches do.
So timeout called here, the first for the Bronx. The Bronx has gone 2 or 3 from deep so far in this game. Ingram passes to Porzingis. There's the pick. The steal. Ferguson, the pass to Joseph. Passes it to Smooth. The tray. They grab their own miss. The Bronx, they've gone 6 of 10 from the field in this ballgame. And a strong finish with 2 hands.
I like the fact that he led his teammate right to the ideal spot. You don't always throw it to your teammate. You throw it to where he needs to be.
The Timberwolves have gone 8 of 11 in the first quarter. They'll take that percentage any night. Joseph, the pass to Ferguson. To the paint. Here's Jackson. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
Yeah, the officials didn't need to talk that one over. It was obvious.
The Timberwolves have gone 1-for-1, making their previous attempt at the line. Both teams will make substitutions. And he sinks the second. Rose with the ball. Now the pass to Ingram. Back to Rose. Puts up a three. That one's no good. 0 of 1 to begin the game. Joseph with the ball. Working on Rose. Jackson. And a big bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in. Jackson's got his third basket of the night right there. Outside Rose. Out to the wing. Launches it. Rebounded by Jackson.
Hey, they got the shot they wanted off of that pick, but it just doesn't fall.
Yeah, it didn't go down, but you'll take that shot every single time, Greg. That's good offense.
Hayward with some nice D.
Those are chances almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points, but the D, just enough to keep him out of rhythm.
Pass to Ferguson. Here's Joseph. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game.
I guess even he has to miss one of those once in a while.
Rose, that's good.
And I like how he puts himself in position there to finish on the break.
Yeah, you know, that's what we call seeing and feeling the game. Excellent read of how that play was going to develop and where the ball was going. That's stuff that you oftentimes can't teach, Greg.
Jackson gets the bucket.
That's his fourth straight make right out the chute. He's setting a pretty high standard for himself here.
Just like you draw it up before you come out.
Now, here's Rose. They set the screen. Here's Ingram. And a clear foul there as he shot the triple. He'll go to the line for three free throws. First trip to the free throw line for him in this one. Both shots good from the stripe.
And what an advantage. You really feel like you can always trust him when he's at the line.
Now here's Joseph. Pass to Ferguson. On the wing, Jackson. Just five to shoot, and he gets it to go. And the Timberwolves lead by three.
Boy, they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing that ball into the paint. Smash mouth basketball.
And Clark, it's a strategy that has served them well during the course of this first half.
Inside, intercepted. And here is Joseph. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. Pass to Rose. Nice ball movement there by the Bronx. Here's Ingram. Lays it up, and despite of the excellent defense at that.
And when it comes to size, it's not a one-on-one matchup that favors him.
Well, you wouldn't know it with that finish, I tell you. I mean, that took a little bit of creativity right there.
So the Timberwolves call their first timeout. Bairstow, he's checked in for the Timberwolves. Bronx making a switch here. Minnesota in the lead. And there's the pass to Ferguson. Jackson has the open look. And once again off the by Minnesota. The Bronx has gotten just 2 of 6 to fall from three-point range so far in the first. And they take the lead. And the Bronx leads by one.
They are not rotating nearly quickly enough on defense down low. Got to get quicker there.
Just no resistance on the interior.
Minnesota with the ball. And they call an illegal screen here. And while we have a chance, let's now take a look at the NBA's season assist leaders. The fourth spot held by Gordon Hayward.
And it seems like he's taking it on his shoulders to get every one of his teammates involved in the offense here in the postseason. What a passing display.
1:32 left in the first. They've definitely hit that groove offensively.
They sure have, guys. I mean, really aggressive. And I like that posture and mindset. Stay aggressive.
Greg, you like groove, don't you?
I do. Let's groove tonight, Kevin. And matter of fact, let's just stay in the attack mode that we're seeing from these guys. They're getting whatever they want. They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And when you make five in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too.
Jackson kicks to Bairstow. That's good. And it's Jackson with the assist that time. Bairstow's got his first points in this one. Knocked away. Ferguson, the pass to Joseph. There's the screen. Outside Jackson. Shot clock at 6. He kicks to Bairstow. Bronx grabs the miss. Fast break. The Bronx. Rose with the ball. And Hayward at the stuff.
Big time finish. Emphatic.
He hangs on the rim, too, just for good measure.
Yeah, but guys, nothing wrong with a little bit of showboating every now and then.
Outside Jackson. Here's Smooth. How's that for an answer? Right back with the dunk.
Tell you what, he's not an easy guy to stop when he's got his sight on the rim.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher.
Did he just go chop-chop there with that one hand? Tomahawk slam.
A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. The Bronx leads by just one. And back in a moment as we'll get a... And welcome back to this Game 7 as we get ready to get back into the action. And looking at what we've seen from the Bronx, what do you guys think?
It's been about the pace. You can see they're going to try to keep this game in the open floor.
Yeah, and, you know, it's been a tempo that they like, and they're getting some easy buckets in transition here.
They've got Towns, and it's Ferguson in at the 2 spot. So that's the lineup for Minnesota. Diamantopoulos, defended by Paul. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Paul. And they'll turn it over. Could not get off a shot. 24-second violation. And for the Bronx, they're shooting it very well tonight, around 57%. Pass to Porzingis. Dishes it to Hardaway. Passes it to Porzingis. Shot from 12. It's rebounded by Towns. The Timberwolves trail. Feeds it to Joseph. There's the pass to Ferguson. Wing shot on the way. No good. Outside Hardaway. Pass to Yates. Here's Porzingis. Fires the 3. And a great assist by Paul as that one goes in. Porzingis has got the first basket of the second quarter for the Bronx. And for the Timberwolves, their shooting percentage, 59%. The offense is running smoothly. Diamantopoulos, guarded by Hardaway. Clock at 4. The Timberwolves need to get a shot off here. The rejection by Paul. The Bronx leading by 4. Hardaway, no good.
That's really too easy a chance to miss, guys. He needs to be more aggressive and focused on his finishes.
And here in the second, 2 minutes gone by. There's a good screen. And Paul over to help. And out of bounds as the Bronx gains possession.
Well, that's inexcusable to throw a pass that far off the mark.
The Bronx has gone 3 of 7 tonight from three-point territory. fires from the wing. Rebound, Minnesota. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
Joseph, the pass to Chapman. And out of bounds as the Bronx gains possession.
That is just a careless turnover. You've got to be smarter in those exchanges.
Ingram passes to Paul. And he sinks that one, hitting the back of the rim on the way in. Paul's got 8 points.
And when you've got that much of a size advantage on your defender, that's how you take advantage of it.
Diamantopoulos, guarded by Hardaway. To the wing right side. Here's Joseph. The Timberwolves again can't hit. The Bronx leading by 6. Here's the screen. Passes it to Yates. Out to Hardaway. And the 3 off target.
Not able to find it here in the second. He's off stride and off track just a bit after that one he had earlier.
They need this one. Puts it up from 12. Another miss by Minnesota.
Not pretty. You just got to shake off a miss like that.
He dishes it to Paul. Soft touch off the glass. And now it's an 8-point Bronx lead.
And you're not going to pass up that kind of one.
Now Joseph, still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Diamantopoulos, guarded by Hardaway. From 13, in the hoop for his third make from the field. He's 3 for 4 thus far in the contest. The Bronx leading by 6. Here's Yates. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2. Breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for the Bronx.
Tell you what, guys, they're showing us a lot of energy early on and racking up those fast break points.
And also defensively, they've been able to cause some turnovers tonight, and that also builds confidence and gives you momentum.
Now, here's Joseph. He's guarded closer. There's the screen. Shot clock at 5. 3-pointer. The shot goes in. First of the night. He's 1 for 3 to start the game.
Man, that is not an easy shot right there. I mean, he had to get it off over a much taller defender.
Yeah, he needed to add just a little more loft on that one because of the size mismatch, and he did it perfectly.
The Bronx, they've gone 3 of 7 shooting the ball here in the second quarter. Out to the right wing. Porzingis passes to Paul. Pulls it from the elbow. Oh, yes, he did. 5 up and 5 down for him so far.
I love how he used his height advantage on that shot.
And he had the nice soft touch with it, too.
And Joseph kicks to Towns. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot 2. Minnesota shooting their 4th and 5th attempts at the free throw line tonight. That free throw, no good.
At the line for your Timberwolves, Carl Anthony Towns.
He hits the 2nd from the line. And that's out of bounds. The Bronx will retain possession.
Oh, nice play there to get a hand on that pass and tip it out of bounds.
Just a whisker away from coming up with the steal there.
Ingram passes to Porzingis. Now here's Paul. Defense is right there. Off the screen. And the shot is good, dropping in off the front of the rim. Paul's got the lead up to 8 now for the Bronx. Ferguson, the pass to Joseph. Towns sets the pick for Joseph. The pass to Chapman. Clock at 6. Towns sets the pick for Joseph. Off the screen. Bronx grabs the miss.
And that's a well-contested shot.
Well, we've seen him before. He does not allow you to just get easy baskets. He's always going to make you work for it.
And how about that one-man fast break?
I love the power finish at the end of it, too.
Pass to Ferguson. Hardaway with the steal. Here's Yates. It's deflected, and they'll keep possession. Beyond the arc. Rebound, Minnesota. Towns has got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Joseph with the ball. Passes it to Wolf. And Paul over to help. 5 to shoot. The pass to Wolf. Well-placed jumper from the free throw line.
Well, he knew how many inches he had over the guy. I mean, let's face it. Good decision to just rise up and take the jump shot. And a little bit of showmanship there as he increases the lead.
Oh, I like that. That's got to be, though, a tough pill for the defense to swallow.
Well, he's a guy that you know can hurt you with his passing. And right there, he does some damage with his finishing, too.
Yeah, enough scoring on the inside there. I think it's time for him to send a message to his team.
Yeah, you're exactly right. I guarantee you this talk centers around cutting down on all of those points coming in the paint. They've got to show more resistance there.
Looking at who's out there now for the Timberwolves. Smooth checked in for Towns. And it's Jackson in for Joseph. Here's Smooth. Takes the assist and lays it in. Picked out the pass nicely. Smooth's got his second basket of the night. Jackson against Rose. They set the pick. Pass to Ingram. Fires from the wing. And that's good off the glass that time. He's got 10.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the league.
The dish now to Jackson. Deep three-point range, and it's McCullough with the rebound. McCullough's got his 3rd rebound on the night. Nice ball movement there by the Bronx. Ingram, that's another one for him, his 5th in just 7 shots.
Well, I tell you what, I need to see some more assertiveness out of these defenders. They're not getting the job done.
That's a great point. 10 of the last 12 points they've allowed have come at the rim.
Outside Jackson. Out to the right wing. Here's Ferguson. Not enough on that one as it misses.
Well, it's hard to believe that we're at this point in the game and he still hasn't registered a single point.
There's a screen. Down low. Here's McCullough. It's good. This time the assist from Rose. Rose has got 3 assists tonight.
Their interior has been inferior defensively. It has got to tighten up.
You're right on target there, Greg. Of the last 10 points they've allowed, 8 have come from in close.
Here's Smooth. Shot off the screen, and it's McCullough with the rebound. McCullough's got his 4th rebound in this one. Here's Ingram. It's blocked. And now Minnesota on the fast break.
Oh, wow. Jackson!
It's a beautiful jam.
And with that speed, once he took off, the D just had no chance of getting back.
Well, I think they did the right thing. I mean, just give up the 2 points and move forward. Hey, discretion is the better part of valor sometimes. Write that one down, game players. Discretion is the better part of valor.
And that replay is sponsored by Kia, the Kia Slam Cam, giving us a great look at that one. Alexander gets the bucket. Timberwolves trail by 14. Jackson passes to Chapman. Here's Smooth. It's in. It's his third field goal of the game. He's 3 for 5. 1:14 left in the second quarter. Kicks to Hayward. Passes to Ingram. This one for 3. Rebound, Minnesota.
Hard to figure out how he doesn't knock that one down. No defender in sight.
The pass to Smooth. And he banks in the layup. Smooth's got 8 points.
You always hear about chemistry. That's a perfect example, knowing where each other is at all times.
And there's the feed to Rose. Pass to Ingram. Here's Alexander. The little short-range fadeaway off target. Shot and game clock separated by 5. To the inside. And it's blocked. And here comes Hayward, leading the fast break. And the shot is good. 14 points for him.
What a job he's doing here. I mean, his second quarter has been even better than his first. And that was pretty good.
There's the pick. Outside Jackson. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line.
And he just big boyed it right there. The height advantage he's got down low, really difficult for them to defend.
Now here's Rose. And that's not going to go. And we finished one half of basketball. The Bronx on top, up by 9. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
Kevin, I have Derrick Rose. And Derrick, you guys were scoring pretty nicely as a unit here tonight. How do you facilitate that?
Just be more.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back, everybody. This is Ernie Johnson alongside Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. Thank you for joining us live inside this sold-out arena. We are rocking and rolling. For the Bronx, they've been playing extremely tough, and you can feel that they believe they can come away tonight with the championship. If they come out of the locker room with that same emotion we saw in the first half, they may very well do just that. Shaq, let's get your insight on the visiting team.
They had a focus to working inside, and it's working, Ernie. They've done a great job of recognizing mismatches, a.k.a. barbecue chicken down low, taking advantage. He can't guard that man down there, Ernie. The entry passes have been sharp, and it's led to a lot of points. When you control the paint, you control the game, and they've done that so far.
Kenny, let's get your insight on the Timberwolves.
Well, right now, they're getting a little embarrassed on the defensive end. They got outshot in the first half. But that's because no one put their foot down on defense to stop it. So in the second half, they need to play much more disruptive defensively. They have to do whatever it takes.
That's going to do it for now, as the second half is just about ready to get started. We'll see you later.
Welcome back to our coverage of the NBA Finals. More action straight ahead. So on the floor for the Bronx, Porzingis is out there with Hayward. Then there's Tim Hardaway Jr. And it's Paul in at center. There's the pick. Shoots a 3, and he gets it to go. He's got 11. Here's Hardaway. Porzingis. Shoots a fader. Bounces high on the rim and flops. Porzingis has got 12.
He's their go-to guy, and when he shoots the ball like he has today, that's what the scoreboard usually looks like.
And for those of you tuning in, we're about a minute into the second half. Jackson misses.
That's something they need to do more of. Get after it on the glass. Go get those boards.
Clark, it wouldn't hurt. Some extra possessions would definitely help narrow the gap and maybe swing the momentum.
Such a wide open look. 6 points for him.
A wide open three. They need much better communication defensively.
Here's the screen. Towns sets the pick for Jackson. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line. The Timberwolves have gone 4 of 6 so far from the line, missing a couple.
When you're hot, you're hot. And that's certainly been the case for Jackson. He's got 17 points and the assist numbers tremendous.
His court vision is on par with anybody. I mean, he could not pass the ball any better than he is right now.
Dishes it to Paul. Outside Hardaway. Good, and Paul gets the assist. Paul's got 4 assists in the game.
3 for 3, and that's always a good way to start the second half.
They set the pick. 3-pointer. Bronx grabs the miss. Paul's got his 3rd rebound on the night. Feeds to Hayward. Passes to Ingram. Paul outside. 6 on the shot clock. There's the pass to Ingram for the 3. No luck. The Timberwolves go the other way with it.
This offense's first miss after 3 straight makes to start the second half.
Oh, that's terrific defense there. That's how you protect the rim.
Hardaway with it. Guarded now by Jackson. Ingram passes to Paul. Oh, that's blocked. Here's Chapman, and the layup is good after a nice loop pass.
Great hustle to turn the block shot into a fast break hoop. That's a big-time play.
You know, I think he just wants to tinker with the game plan a little bit, and I think that's a wise timeout.
And part of it, too, Greg, was he saw some things going on out there that he didn't care for.
And now we're 3 minutes into the 3rd quarter of play. And here is Hardaway. He's got 9. Now Joseph. And the foul called on Tim Hardaway Jr. Hardaway with the steal.
That steal was the product of active hands and outstanding defensive awareness there.
Sinks the triple. 17 points in the game.
They're going back to the 3-point shot over and over and over.
And they may have found the Achilles heel of this defense. That was their 9th straight point from beyond the arc.
The dish to Joseph. Hardaway with the steal. Pass break. Here we go. Here's Porzingis. That drops, and it comes off the assist from Hardaway. Porzingis has got the lead up to 14 now for the Bronx. The Timberwolves have gone 3 of 6 in the 3rd quarter, 50% from the field. Here's Diamantopoulos. It falls for his 5th field goal of the night. Now shooting 5 for 8.
You know, if you're only looking at the way he's played offensively, you'd think his team would have the lead.
Kicks it to Hardaway. They set the pick. Pass to Ingram. The 3. But they recover it. The offensive rebound. Hardaway against Jackson. The feed to Paul. Nice ball movement there by the Bronx. Shot clock at 6. Goes up again. He squares up and sinks it. Paul's got 16 points.
And he's really made the most of his opportunities today. I mean, he needs to keep working for those kinds of looks.
That was a good time to call the timeout to try to settle everybody down and get back into their offensive rhythm. They've been coughing up the rock an awful lot.
Minnesota calls timeout. And as the coaches go to the clipboard to outline their strategy during the timeout, the players getting a chance to rehydrate. with some Gatorade. That's key to staying fresh all the way to the final whistle.
And, Kevin, it really is. And every one of these players knows it. They're all making sure to stay hydrated. It's impossible to play your A game if you're not getting enough to drink, especially towards the end of games when the physical toll of a long contest really starts to add up.
They get a belt, and two shots coming up at the line as he gets fouled on the shot.
That's his third personal foul.
And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the Bronx.
Guys, their play close to the hoop has been great all game.
And we're also seeing that power game on the interior. Really just putting on a clinic when you talk about post play.
And that one falls for Jackson. Both free throws good from Jackson. The Bronx leading by 12. Hayward outside. Here's Porzingis. He's got 14. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
And this collapse we've seen by their interior defense, it's really the reason why they struggled and are in such a hole.
The Bronx, they put up good numbers at the charity stripe, converting 6 of 7. Now, here's Joseph, guarded by Hardaway. Outside Jackson, just 5 to shoot. He feeds it to Joseph. Beyond the arc. And there's the call on Carl Anthony Towns. And that'll be his third foul so far. The Bronx has gone 3 of 5 with the long ball since entering the second half. Pass to Paul. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
And that assist got him a little nod from his teammate after that one.
Joseph with the ball. They set the pick. Here's Diamantopoulos. Another miss by Minnesota.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
And Hardaway gets it to go.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
Great ball movement.
Timberwolves trail by 18. They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going.
Nice job creating for the easy deuce.
Assist goes to Corey.
And for the Bronx, they're shooting a smooth 58% from the field. Everything going according to plan for them on that end. The shot by Hayward, wide open. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
Even though he isn't having the best of game from the floor, it hasn't seemed to hurt him.
Dishes it to Jackson. Pocket 4, and it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Paul. And some changes here for the Bronx. Alexander's checked in for Porzingis, for Gordon Hayward. And it's Rose in for Hardaway. Here's Ferguson, and lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot 2.
That's his first personal foul.
He's getting his first free throw attempt of the night right now.
Ferguson.
No good on the free throw. Minnesota making a switch here. Bairstow's checked in. And he's good on the second.
The story in the first half was their low free throw percentage. They've corrected that here in the second half, and hopefully they can build on it as this game continues to progress.
Feeds to Rose. Here's Yates. No good on the triple.
Rare you'll see him miss such an open look.
Passes it to Smooth. It's good. The assist this time from Jackson. 10 points for Smooth. The Bronx leading by 13. Now here's Rose. There's the screen. Pass to McCullough. Back to Rose. Nice ball movement there by the Bronx. Here's Paul. Hits some rim on the way in, and the bucket's good. Paul's got 20 points.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
Minnesota calls timeout. A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Thank you, Kevin. Well, I was able to listen in on the Timberwolves head coach talking to his team. The focus of the discussion was getting their offense to run through smooth. Coach is looking for big things from him throughout the rest of this game on the offensive end. A lot of the scoring burden will fall on him. Clearly, some adjustments there had to be made because the time left for a comeback is quickly running out. Kevin, over to you.
And thanks for that story, Doris.
It doesn't really matter who starts a break with how he runs the floor. He seems to always be the one who finishes it.
Yeah, he is so fun to watch and how he attacks the rim at full speed like that, man. It's something to behold the way that guy gets to the rim.
That was a nice replay brought to you by Kia. And he gets it back. Jackson misses.
He's going to play his way right onto the bench and out of the game if he continues to shoot it like he has so far in this quarter.
And here's Rose. They set the pick. There's the pass to Ingram. They get the rebound. Back to Rose. Inside. Here's Ferguson. Alexander grabs the board.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
For Minnesota, they have shot the ball pretty well from the line, going 8 of 11. And he can't get the first one. He hits the second from the line. The Bronx leading by 16. There's a good screen. Comes up empty down low. Minnesota's gone 1-4 in three-point shots here in the third. 9 feet out. And he gets that one to go off the front iron.
Look at the space he had on that one, though. There's an obvious speed mismatch between the two.
Pass to McCullough. Outside Rose. Off the pick. And there's a nice one-handed slam.
And did you see the screen that was set for him? I mean, that was how he got to the hoop.
It was the classic screen play. It won't show up in the box score, but that screen deserves an assist.
Absolutely, Kevin. I mean, that took the defender right out of the play.
With the prospect of making a big lead even bigger.
Yeah, and they've got to jump at the chance to actually stretch this thing out even more.
Good point. Kicks it out to Paul. Just five to shoot. Stolen. And here comes Jackson leading the fast break. Poked away. Fast break, the Bronx.
Oh, wow.
That's a beautiful jam.
And with that speed, once he took off, the D just had no chance of getting back.
Well, I think they did the right thing. I mean, just give up the 2 points and move forward. Hey, discretion is the better part of valor sometimes. Write that one down, game players. Discretion is the better part of valor.
And that one's good. The Bronx leading by 14. They set the screen. Paul, right side, unloads from 13. And the Bronx tacks on two more.
Well, I tell you what, when you get this kind of effort and efficiency from him, they're a really hard team to beat.
36 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. Jackson passes to Smooth. Can't hit. The Bronx goes the other way with it.
It's a +5 advantage for them in the rebounding category after that board.
Very steady with their work on the interior. Really a well-rounded effort overall.
Ingram guarded by Jackson. 6 second difference between the shot and game clock. Pass to Ingram. Nice ball movement there by the Bronx. Here's Paul. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
Yeah, easy call.
Yeah, you can hear the smack all the way over here where we are.
He's made two of his three attempted tonight. Both free throws good from Paul. Ferguson, guarded by Hardaway. Rob. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. The Bronx leads by 18. And fourth quarter basketball will be coming your way on 2K Sports right after this. Again with the fourth quarter, might not come down to the wire, but you never know. The Bronx leading by 18. They got Jackson. And it's Ferguson in at the two-guard position. So that's the Timberwolves 5. There's the pick. It's Jackson with the drive.
Jackson!
Nasty. Absolutely filthy.
And the building is stunned, partner. He dug deep into his bag of tricks.
I tell you
there.
What, I hope he keeps that one handy. I want to see that one again.
Rock hard finish there, guys.
And only one hand needed for that one.
Yeah, and sometimes that's all you need.
Stolen away. To the inside, here's Alexander. Rebound Minnesota. Towns has got 6 rebounds in the game. Jackson up top, defended by Hayward. Now here's Towns. Defense right on him. 6 on the shot clock. Ferguson, the pass to Chapman. Let's go. Hayward grabs the board. The Bronx, they've gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. Passes to Ingram. Here's Porzingis. And the three ball is good. And the Bronx leads by 21.
It has been a three-point barrage for them since halftime.
Not sure if it's been by design or simply by accident, but either way, it has been impressive.
The pass to Chapman. And it's blocked. They recover it. Towns kicks to Jackson. Sinks the three-pointer. Jackson's got 12 points in just the second half.
It took a long time for him to get that first triple. Let's see now, though, if he can get going.
And that's out of bounds. The Bronx will retain possession.
You take a risk with those long passes. They're lucky the D couldn't collect it.
Last quarter of play, about 2 minutes in now. Porzingis passes to Hardaway. They set the pick. Down low. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
That's his first personal foul.
The first one falls.
Two shots.
Both shots good from the stripe. Timberwolves trail by 20. Here's Diamantopoulos. Number 12 goes in. He's made 7 of 12 now. Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Here's Ingram. And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line.
And really, it looks like he may just try to take this thing over on his own and really build that lead up.
The Timberwolves making a switch here. Joseph's checked in. Just over 2.5 minutes played now here in the final quarter of regulation. Chapman the pass to Joseph. 5 on the clock. Gets the front of the rim and out. The Bronx leading by 21. Hayward with the ball. Picked up by Joseph. Here's Porzingis. Off target with his 3. The Timberwolves have gone 3 of 6 from the field so far in the fourth quarter. To the inside, Towns laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Really good awareness right there on the assist.
Bronx timeout called.
Timeout called, the Bronx.
You know what? I think he thinks he can make a few improvements to how things are going on right now.
Yeah, and you know, coaches always are looking for ways to tweak things and change it up a little bit, no matter what the situation is. That's what coaches do.
The Bronx has gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Ingram passes to Hardaway. Hayward kicks to Alexander. Parked down low that time, and he got the 3-second call.
Minnesota ball.
A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. There's the dish to Jackson. He kicks to Towns. Plenty of space. Alexander grabs the board. Alexander's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Here's Porzingis.
Bronx time. Porzingis. That's the second personal.
Timberwolves trail by 19. Now Joseph. Outside Jackson. From 16 feet away, he can.
Jackson!
Jackson's got 7 points here in this quarter.
What handles? He broke the D down to the ground with that move.
And for the Bronx, they're shooting 56% in this game, really stringing quality possessions together offensively. Here's Hayward. Here's Alexander. And he dunks it after the pick frees him up.
A long windup and a strong follow-through on that one-hand jam.
He's not going to mess that one up for sure.
I sure hope not.
Tries it from the top of the key. Alexander grabs the board. Alexander's got his 8th rebound here tonight. It's tipped. Outside Jackson. Lands soft on the front of the rim and drops. Jackson's got 30.
Despite the play of the team, I think he's had an outstanding game. He's really done well here.
Here's Hardaway. That's good. And the Bronx leads by 19.
Boy, he's having a great half here. Exactly the opposite of the first.
Joseph dishes to Jackson. Here's the teardrop.
Hey, I like creativity and a circus finish as much as anybody. But you better be sure you got a chance to make it.
And he gets the bucket. He's got 24.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last 3 field goals have come from inside the paint area.
There's got to be a wall of defense when it comes to attacking the paint. Plain and simple.
Here's the screen. 6 to shoot. He dishes it to Towns. Bronx grabs the miss.
Right thing there to stay that tight on him and really try to keep him out of his comfort zone.
Out to Hayward. Pass to Porzingis. Misses the 3. Alexander passes to Ingram. Hayward outside. Nice ball movement there by the Bronx. To the middle. Here's Porzingis. Can't get it to fall. Timberwolves trail by 21. Bronx making a switch here. Hall's checked in.
That's his 4th personal foul.
Joseph with the ball. Here's Chapman, and a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
And not the prototype power forward, but he has tremendous athletic ability.
There's a screen. Ingram passes to Porzingis. Here's Hardaway. That one falls through. It's his sixth make from the floor this game. Now 6 for 10.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agendas.
Yeah, and it's really fun to see that kind of unselfishness. Really hard not to appreciate all the assists they've racked up.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
And really a reflection of their superior effort level to this point. It seems to me they've gone after this win a little bit more.
And that's his second triple of the half. None for him going into the break.
And at the top of the key, Towns puts up a three. Offensive rebound. The Bronx has gotten off 4 3-pointers in the final quarter, and two of them have fallen. Out to the right wing. Here's Paul. And good. Got the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim. Paul's got 12 points here in the second half. Diamantopoulos. Defended by Hayward. There's the pick. Outside Jackson. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Will it go? Can't hit. The Bronx goes the other way with it. Ingram guarded by Jackson. Here's Ingram. Takes it into the teeth of the D and converts the layup. He has 29.
And he's starting to show that killer instinct this quarter, looking to extend the lead.
Outside Jackson.
Well, one more and that's it. He'll be DQ, disqualified. He's got to be able to defend without picking up that last disqualifying foul.
And a new group getting ready for the Bronx. Now off the inbound, and the dunk by Towns.
Sheer unadulterated power right there. I mean, he ripped it down with both hands.
Absolutely. A resounding dunk.
Just a take-no-chance slam by the big fella.
He got right to the cup using that screen. Paul's got 14 points now in the second half.
Boy, that was a rugged screen set there, fellas, and the defense didn't even try to go through that.
There's Stowe. McDermott, no one around him, buries the long-range jumper.
Boy, I tell you what, he loves getting looks like that from the three-point line. No one near him. That's a warm-up jumper for him.
Outside Rose. Inside, Paul. And he jams it with authority.
The shooting percentage continues to elevate here in the second half.
Well, as a group, they've been harmonic since the break. In sync. Good team basketball resulting in high-quality shots.
2 minutes. Kicks to Towns. And a wide-open look for Lynn. And there are the Timberwolves with another bucket. The Bronx has gotten off 4 3-pointers in the final quarter, and two of them have fallen. At the elbow, Paul. Minnesota with the rebound.
How about him there, just bodying him up to make him alter the trajectory on that shot.
Definitely some very sound defense played on that trip. Boy, did they ever make a mess out of that one. A terrible turnover.
Minnesota making a switch here. And for the Bronx, they're shooting about 59% from the floor offensively. They've been running without a hitch.
And wow, that's the end of an epic journey taken by both these teams in unbelievable fashion. Get the NBA title rings ready, folks, for the Bronx.
And this was one that never really was in doubt, I thought, Stephen Clark. An all-around dominant performance. Clark, and you kind of thought that maybe even going into the game.
I certainly did, and they just cracked it open and made it an in seat. No contest.
Yeah, I like that.
And what a huge standout performance it was for Paul. He was really important under the basket, making the plays down low and getting position to pull in rebounds.
That is good.
And they're really in a good position here, thanks in part to the way he's been able to score the basketball.
Lynn with it, and Rose picks him up defensively. Pass to Hanson. There's the pick. 43 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Passes it to Wolf. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. There's Lynn with the three, but they get it back. Bairstow kicks to Lynn. 23 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Gets another look. And off the front iron, and in it goes.
What do you do with that guy? With his handles, he abuses defenders.
And they can just dribble the ball until the buzzer.
Yeah, exactly. They got to be happy with the outcome here.
Elated, you're right. Now the feed to Rose. Ball left side. Misses there. And they've done it, the new NBA champions. What a moment it is right now to see the team who played so well together enjoying, Clark, this NBA championship moment.
Well, Kevin, it's awesome to be here to witness what happened tonight.
And seeing this team come together over the course of the season and on into the playoffs, what a joy. I mean, there is no better champion the league could have asked for.
And a pleasure here at 2K Sports to be with you all season long. Good night, everyone. We'll be right back.
So fast.